With a month remaining in session, Senator, the week rather, spent on, for the most part, the budget for the upcoming fiscal year.
Yes, and what a budget it is. Compared to what most people consider a budget, this thing is large. That's putting it mildly. But we are projecting to spend nearly $30 billion next year. We included some cost to continue increases in various categories, trying to keep the services that we do provide at least current level. We also managed, in accordance with what the governor had as a priority, there were raises given to state employees, which I know they haven't had in some cases quite a while. So, you know, people do like to be rewarded for working hard. So that was included. As far as my own thoughts on the process, I think that a lot of people spend a lot of time, and one of the things that I'd like to work on over the off season and into next year is how do we implement some performance metrics so that, you know, we really can see what we're getting for the money that we're spending. So I think we need a little more investment in determining goals that we achieve. But all in all, I think the budget takes care of a lot of things that needed to be taken care of. And so it'll be sent back to the House, and we'll see where we go from there.
I know for you, one of your measures, one of your bills, the reading/dyslexia bill.
Yes, you know, we have some really poor outcomes in our reading in people in the public schools. And in 2016, a measure was passed that was to address people who were below grade level. And many statistics show if you're not reading at grade level by third or fourth grade tops, then, you know, you're really going to struggle throughout the rest of your life. So I did have a bill that I sponsored and actually was going to present it on the floor today, but then did have some additional input from the education establishment and some people outside my immediate circle. So we have a meeting on Monday morning where we will be fine-tuning that, and I think that will come to the floor next week.
At that point, 3 weeks left. Still time to hopefully be able to see that one make it to the finish line.
Yes, I have a commitment from the floor leader, and, you know, I feel good about it. I mean, I think people are looking at scores that students are achieving in their reading and their math, particularly. And so I think it is something that we want to continue working on. I feel good about it getting to the floor. One of the other things that we, you know, it has been finalized pretty much is the highway bonding bill. And I just wanted to let people know, you know, through the various negotiations and the governor wanting to take one route and us maybe in the conservative side wanting to take another route. And we did come to an agreement. I think a highlight of that I'd like people to know is that we will save about $80 million by shortening the bonding period and by not bonding as much as was originally proposed. So I think sometimes people hear something and they think, oh, well, what difference does that make? Well, it makes a huge difference when you're talking about the amounts of money that we're talking about. So we felt good about saving $80 million for Missouri's taxpayers.
A big part about that also is the fact that a lot of these bridges, not only do they need the work, but a lot of them are in rural Missouri.
Yes, they are. There are many bridges in our area that need to be taken care of, and also in, you know, the rest of the state really is largely rural. So a lot of those bridges have kind of been set aside while they try to, you know, maintain the major roadways and the big bridges. And we're also looking at, you know, how do we address the Roachport Bridge? That's a big one. And lots of commerce go up and down I-70. So I think we're, you know, working with the governor and working with MoDOT, I think we'll have a solution for that.
Another one of those policies that the governor is hoping to see come to fruition this year is what's called the fast track legislation.
Yes, you know, we have such a low unemployment rate in the state, and we have a lot of jobs open. And one of the things that the governor has kind of keyed in on is maybe a segment of the population that really doesn't have quite the necessary skills they need to move into some of these positions that we have. So that was the whole thinking behind fast track. We actually met with the governor this week and talked about some of the things that we would like to see in that legislation. And he was very cordial and generous with his time. I think we'll see an agreement on that and something come out on that next week.